Father God, I am yours, I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad, you make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours, every day I will say, Father God, I am yours, I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad, make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad, you make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child of God.
Good morning, boys and girls, and how are you today? Today we're joined by Elaine and Ethan. Say good morning to all the boys and girls, Elaine and Ethan.
Hi, boys and girls.
Good. I hope everyone has been well this week. And we'd like to begin today's lesson. I'll ask Elaine to pray for us so we can start our lesson. Let's all put our hands together.
Let's bow our heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for today. We hope you'll bless us. Please help us through this COVID-19. Oh Lord, we're helping you to heal those people who have COVID-19 and bless us through this Sunday school. Oh Lord, we're blessed, asking you to help Teacher Maureen and other teachers. Oh Lord, we're asking you to bless us and protect us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's start by asking you how your week was. How has your week been, Ethan? What have you done this week?
Hey.
It's been super. Awesome. What have you done this week? Tell me one thing you've done this week.
Yes. We went swimming for my birthday.
Wow, when was your birthday?
On Sunday, on August.
Oh, wow. How many years are you now?
Six.
Six. Happy birthday to you, Ethan. And how about you, Lane? How was your week?
My week was good. We went swimming. Uh-huh. We ate two whole tulikula cake.
Wow. It must have been yummy.
Mm-hmm. To Ronaldo.
A Ronaldo cake. That's your favorite footballer.
I got his head. We also got to see our friends.
Wow.
And I chomped off his head.
I'm sure you missed your friends a lot.
I had lots of fun. Me too.
You too.
This so one sure for two holidays.
My goodness, that sounds like so much fun. I'm sure you can't wait for your birthday again next year.
My birthday is coming up.
When's your birthday, Ling?
November.
Wow, we'll celebrate. We'll be happy and we'll sing for all of you happy birthday.
And then Christmas is coming up. Christmas.
Yes, Christmas is coming in December. Now, I want us to do our lesson for today. Our lesson is called People in the Bible. It's called People in the
Bible.
This is a Bible. This is my Bible. In the Bible, there are a lot of people in the Bible. Can you name for me anyone you know in the Bible? Yes, Elaine?
Jacob.
Ethan?
Hi.
Anybody you know in the Bible?
Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve. Elaine, somebody else in the Bible?
Samuel.
Ethan, someone you know in the Bible?
King Solomon.
Yes, King Solomon. Okay, one more each. Elaine, one more person from the Bible?
Daniel.
Ethan, one more person from the Bible?
Isaac.
Yes, Ethan. Isaac. Good, very good. You've done a good job. There are all those people in the Bible.
I have today one. Our,
Yes, tell me.
Abraham.
Yes, Abraham is in the Bible. Now, you can see there are a lot of Bible verses I've put on the screen. The Bible is a book about many people, but the most important person in the Bible is, can you guess who it is?
God.
It's God, and God's son is called?
Jesus.
Yes, Jesus is the most important person in the Bible. Now, the verses on the screen, you can read them later. There's Genesis chapter 5, verse 1 to 32, and then there's Matthew chapter 1, verse 1 to 17. There are a lot of verses, so you can read them later. You want me to say them again so you can write them down?
Yes.
Okay. I'll wait for you. You have your pen?
Yes.
Okay, good. Now, the first one is Genesis chapter 5, from verse 1 to 32. Genesis chapter 5, from verse 1 to 32. Tell me when you're finished so I can tell you the next one. You finished writing Genesis? Okay. And the next one is Matthew chapter 1, verse 1 to 17. You finished writing? Tell me when you finished writing. Then the last one is Matthew chapter 4, verse 18 to 22. Good. Okay, you finished writing all of them?
But I haven't.
It's okay. You can read from what Elaine has written. So all those parts of the Bible, what they tell us is a long, long story. You know that Jesus was related to Adam and Eve? So they tell us the whole story of how from Adam and Eve, then they got their children, and then their children, all the way up to Jesus. And that is called a family tree. It's called a family.
Family tree.
So in Genesis chapter 5, verse 1 to 32, and Matthew 1, 1 to 17, they show us all those people in the Bible who were there before Jesus and up to the time Jesus was born. So let me show you some pictures of those people. Just a moment. And some of the stories that we're going to go through in the Bible. What can you see on the screen?
God made sun, tree, moon, mountains, sea creatures, wild animals, flowers, bushes, and precious one.
Yes, now in the first story in the Bible,
I see a tree, a sun, word which God made. And a mountain, wild animals, flowers, bushes with flowers, a turtle, a leopard, a lion, the sea, a whale, the moon, the stars, the sun.
Good, good job, and true. So in the beginning, we all remember the story how God made everything. God made everything that we see. God made the sky and the sun and the trees and all the animals. So this is how the Bible stories begin. So the first story in the Bible, we begin with how God made everything that we see. Now I'm showing another picture, and I want you to tell me what you see. What can you see?
Adam and Eve, and the truth, and the tree of knowledge.
Yes, now Adam and Eve were the first people that God created. Remember, we're learning the story of the people in the Bible. So the first people God made, what were their names?
Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
Were they there before Jesus came or after Jesus came?
After, before.
Before, yes. They were there before Jesus came to earth. But there are people who, their stories are in the Bible. Let's show another picture. Who is this that you can see now? Who can you see on the
screen?
Noah.
Noah.
Yes, Noah. What do you remember about Noah?
Noah and the ark.
Noah and the ark.
What do you remember about Noah?
He built a ginormous ark because God asked, was coming.
God asked Noah to build an ark because all his people disobeyed him. So he was told to build an ark.
Correct. So Noah was another person in the Bible who God spoke to.
And then there were small windows and a big door.
And a big door so that all the animals could fit and also they could breathe.
Two by two.
Okay, now let's look at another thing. Tell me, what do you see?
Abraham and.
Yes, you've got it right. Sarah. Say Sarah.
Sarah and Isaac.
And Isaac, Abraham. Well done. Yes, Abraham was also in the Bible, and he remembered
Isaac,
and his wife was Sarah, and their child was called Isaac. The special thing about him is he was very old, and his wife was very old, but God gave them a baby called Isaac. So these are more people we're learning about in the Bible. Let's look at another one.
Joseph. Can you see?
What do you remember about Joseph?
Joseph is in the Bible. His brothers betrayed him.
Yes.
Joseph is in the Bible. His brothers threw him in a well. They sold him. And then he went to Egypt. And then he became something.
Also, Joseph became the king.
He became the second to the king in the country of Egypt. So even though his brothers betrayed him and sold him because they were jealous of him, God used him in a mighty way. Good job. I see you guys know your Bible very well. Who's next? Who can you see?
Moses.
What's this? What can you see next to Moses?
The
sea.
What did he do to the sea?
He lifted the waves up so people can get across.
Yes, he lifted his hand holding a staff. Correct. Well done, you guys know your Bible so well. Yes, he parted the Red Sea so that the Israelites could pass in the middle and run. Who were they running away from? They were running away from
the
Egyptians.
From the Egyptians, from the
army. But then he carried all the other good Egyptians, and then Pharaoh's army came, and then Pharaoh and his army got trapped in the Red Sea.
That's true. You guys know your Bible very well. Samuel. Now tell me about Samuel.
Samuel was called 4 times by God.
Yes, he was sleeping. He was a small boy. And he was sleeping in the temple, and God called him, and he thought it was the priest called Eli. You see an old man in the picture?
Yes, his name is Eli.
Correct. So Samuel thought it was God, Eli calling him, but he told him it was God. And Samuel also became a prophet, and he was used by God. Do we still know? Have we reached the time for Jesus or not yet?
Not yet.
All right, let's look at the next one. Who can you see on the screen?
King David.
What do you know about? Tell me about King David. Who's the one who fought with a giant in the Bible?
David.
What did he use? He used a stone and a
sling.
And a sling. And what was the name of the giant?
Goliath.
Yes, David was a small boy, but he defeated a big giant called Goliath, and he became the king.
Because he had trust in God.
He had trust in God. God called him a man after his own heart. And David built because he became king of the Israelites. Yes. Now, who are we at?
Jesus.
Yes. The first picture you can see at the left is when Jesus was born. He was born in a...
He was born in
a manger.
Stable.
Yes. Yes, in a stable. And then in the middle, what can you see in the middle of the screen?
A cross.
A cross. Jesus died on a cross. Jesus came to earth.
Jesus died on the cross to save our sins.
That is true. Jesus is the Son of God, and he came to earth just to die for our sins so that we could be saved. And then the last picture you can see is the tomb that was rolled away, because Jesus did not just die, but he rose again. So today Jesus is alive in heaven, and he's preparing a place for us
to live heaven,
to live forever and ever and ever. Now we finished before Jesus, and Jesus came and died and rose again. Now who can you see on the screen?
Peter.
And there's a picture of somebody dancing there, because Peter was a disciple of Jesus. And after Jesus died, he became an apostle. That means he was the one sharing with everybody about Jesus. So the man you can see dancing in the screen was somebody who came to Peter, and Peter healed him. And that's why he threw up his hands and he danced, because he was healed. He wasn't walking. And because of the power of Jesus, he can walk. And now let's look at the last person. Who is that?
Paul.
What do you remember about Paul? Something special about him? What was his name before?
Paul was a baptism.
Paul used to be called Saul. He used to be called?
Saul.
And he was a bad man. Do you know what Saul used to do?
What?
Saul used to kill Christians. Anybody who said, I believe in Jesus, he used to look for them and kill them. Was that a good thing or a bad thing?
Bad.
And do you know what God did? You can see the photo of him bowing down.
Yes.
God stopped him he was on the road going to kill some Christians, and God stopped him on the road and he made him become
blind.
Yes, I'm happy to hear you know the story. He became blind, and he had to go and look for a man of God who told him why he was blinded by God. And God told him he wanted him to stop killing the Christians. And now Saul became Paul, and he started going around sharing the word of God, and he stopped killing Christians. So he became a Christian himself, and one of the most well-known Christians, and he was the one going around sharing the word of God. So we've learned about many people today. Who can you remember we've learned about?
Jesus!
Mm-hmm.
I could remember creation, Adam and Eve.
Mm-hmm.
There was...
Which other picture did you see?
Noah.
Mm-hmm.
Isaac, Sarah, and...
There was King David.
Yes, King David, and also Samuel and Eli.
And then there was Jesus. And then there was Peter.
Then Paul.
Peter and Paul. So all these people in your Bible... all these people are in the Bible. Some of them were there a long time before Jesus, some were there time of Jesus, and some were there after Jesus. But we learn about all of them in the Bible and all the things God did using them, so that even today we have the word of God. Amen?
Amen.
Can I send you those photos so that you can color them at home?
Yes.
Okay, I'll send them for you through your mommy, and also to all the boys and girls, I'll send for you all those pictures so you can color all the people in the Bible. Thank you so much, Elaine and Ethan. I'm so proud of you, because you're the ones who have actually taught the lesson today. You are telling me all about all the people in the Bible. So let's clap for yourselves. Clap for yourself, Elaine. Clap for yourself, Ethan.
Clap for yourself.
Oh, like this. Okay, let's clap for ourselves. Well done. I'm happy that you know your Bible, and I hope all the boys and girls at home know their Bibles as well as you do. So thank you for joining us for today's lesson. I'm going to ask Ethan to pray for us as we close. Pray for all the boys and girls at home and for all their mommies and daddies, okay?
Yeah, Heavenly Father, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, we come here to bow our heads. Please may we have a good day today, and please may we do a good day tomorrow, and Lord, on Sunday, may we know that it's your day to worship you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
God is good.
Yeah.
All the time.
All the time. God is good, and that's his Okay, thank you. Let's say goodbye. Let's say goodbye to all the boys and girls at home. Let's wave and say bye.
Bye, boys and girls.